So the organization is Kula Pō Hawaii o Papakōlea, Kewalo, Kalāwahine. And it's a community-based nonprofit that has been serving the Hawaiian homestead communities of Papakōlea, Kewalo, and Kalāwahine, and the community at large since 1992. The organization is a 501c3 nonprofit that was formed by Kupuna of Papakolea initially to address education, the negative test scores, or the publications that were coming out in the newspaper around Native Hawaiian children and their test scores in the public schools. So our first program was really around teaching parents how to work with children around testing and being able to really engage with the school in a different manner to advocate on behalf of their children, as well as to learn how to help them through that process. So our first program was actually a teacher apprenticeship program where parents came in and learned teaching skills and got credit courses through Windward Community College in order to help their kids, with homework and different things. Through the years, we have advanced to do education and health, and now are addressing social determinants of health and do a lot around community-based participatory research.
That's absolutely incredible. So teaching parents how to do these types of things, that's a huge gap usually in society. What pushed y'all to be able to pursue this and to fill in that gap?
Well, that was when they were formed in 1992, because the Kupuna during that time, 80s and 90s, every time a school didn't perform well, it was the Native Hawaiian children at Lincoln Elementary or someplace else. That is what they highlighted. And so the Kupuna of Papakolea, we had Dr. Lila Nita was working on her PhD in education. So she came to community and wanted to help in that area. So she worked with the Papakolea Community Association at that time, who formed the nonprofit with Kupuna, who were able to say, this is what we need to take on to ad address literacy and all of that. So early on, it was this idea that we can't address the educational needs of children without involving parents and without involving community. And so the organization, that is where it started, to say that through the 30 years, we are still trying to get parents to understand that, really now it's a partnership that we need to have between community, the school, and parents in order to help kids to be as most successful for some. And
Wonderful.
so,
Okay. Oh, sorry. I thought
I
you were
don't,
done.
no, go ahead.
Apologies. So I wanted to do three, I guess, like not interviews, but three segments of the interview with you. And we were going to do Kupuna, your work with Kupuna, your work with Keiki, and then your work with health prevention. So let's start with your Kupuna programs.
Okay, the Kupuna programs. So our Kupuna programs, we have right now, we have the Kupuna Community Care Network. The Kupuna Community Care Network is programs where we have Kupuna in space on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and we do various things. So they do kanikapila because they love to engage in music, and it's about keeping Kupuna busy, socialization. We do a monthly health topic with Nicole Lum or Mea Alani Lum from Ke Olo Mamo. We do Tai Chi. The Kupuna over this past year have gotten involved intergenerationally and working with youth. They're doing, lei making and then teaching our kids in our after school program. So working together with them. We do a project with service learning with the university where we do home visits for some of our Kupuna who are homebound. And so we work with students from nursing students from UH, as well as social work students from HPU and the various universities over the last 10 years to look at, accessing and going in and do wellness checks for our kupuna, and to see those who are unable to come out, because Papakōlea's terrain is such that sometimes access or coming out can be a challenge. So we do home visits with staff. So we have a staff of community health workers, social workers, and primarily the majority of our staff are born and raised Papakōlea, Kewalo, Kalāwahine. And so taking care of Kupuna from very early on has been, a priority to make sure that they are getting what they need. They like to go out and do different activities. And so since COVID had kind of isolated them, we take them out on different excursions when we can. This year they've gone to, what is it, Kilohana down at Waikiki Shell. The Elks has hosted our kupuna to have activities there. And so really keeping them busy, keeping them engaged in various topics. They have hula classes with Hina Huakalei, who's from Papakolea. So she's doing hula for our kupuna in a program there. So a lot of varied activities to keep them busy. Last year at the end of the year, the Kanikapila group performed at Alamoana Shopping Center stage, and they're prepared to do that again this year. They've performed at Iolani Palace on that stage. And so those things that keep them busy. We define kupuna as those age 55 and older, so that we can begin to address those social needs and that things that people are needing early on for retirement, health screening, and various things in community. We not only serve those from Papakōlea, but we have kupuna that are coming in from Hawaii Kai, from Pearl City, those who have a connection or an affinity to others that live in Papakōlea.
Wonderful. Well, what has been the reaction to from the kupuna you're helping, their ohana, and the community at large?
Well, I think one of the big reactions have been just recently, we were recognized as an organization by Papaʻolelokahi. We received the Kaʻanohi Award for advancing health and wellness in the native and well-being in the Native Hawaiian community. And we were the first community organization to receive that award. So a couple of weeks ago, we were at Washington Place to receive that award as a result of the work that we're doing in community and in health. And so I think, we know families are appreciative, very supportive of the work that's being done, because we also emphasize being supportive of caregivers and, listening to the needs of community.
That's amazing. I mean, this is really, I will talk to you about that in a minute. So let's move on to your keiki program. So tell me about those.
Okay, so our keiki programs, during COVID, all of our programming with keiki was paused, right? Because we couldn't do much in person. We did do some things online. So what we noticed while we were in that COVID situation, the K-5, they were engaged online. Our middle school to high school, we kind of lost connection to them. So last school year, we restarted our program. So we have Lama Kū, which is our after-school program at the community center for K-5. And that's culturally based, where they come in for homework assistance and learning, different Hawaiian values. We also have what we call our junior leader program. And that's for our middle school and high school students. And they come in and they are learning, basic skills, but really to be connected. They at the and I'm going to share some things with you that will help you get a sense of that, because the kids did a video about community and what they learn that we do. But you know, they come in to socialize, to do projects. Junior leaders, the kids call it their job because they get a stipend, an incentive for participation, as well as focusing on their grades and school attendance and rebuilding that connection. They actually did an outer island excursion. And for many, that was their first time leaving Oahu. And so they worked on projects to be able to do that. They did presentations to us about ali'i. They cook, they you know, bake cookies, learn to bake cookies and different things. So different activities that, once again, that will reconnect them to each other, because this whole idea of everything is they text each other in the same room across the room, but coming in and doing a check-in with each other, trying to make sure they're supportive of one another and learning more about community and space. And this year they were really engaged. The beginning of the year we took Kupuna to Waiole Tea House to say what did they see. And one of the things is they wanted to be more engaged with the kids. So they've gone to like spaghetti factory with Kupuna to have dinner, where they're one-on-one engaging and talking with Kupuna, trying to do intergenerational things. They've had lei making classes, also got penny leis and different things with Kupuna, so that they can learn to engage in that respect. And just the sharing in that space, they come into space and they enjoy joining the kupuna in their hula class just to learn more and be in that, because many now are not around their grandparents as such. So things are shifting and changing. So as well as doing that in community, we are very supportive of our school partnerships with Lincoln, Paoa, Stevenson, and Roosevelt. At Lincoln, we have one of our community health workers who's there, funded to be there part-time at the school. And so we help to support like bingo nights, getty dinner, movie night, to bring, once again, parents and families back into the school. We do an annual Ohana Health Fair, where the kids are all invited to participate in an art contest for prizes. At the middle school level, we are making sure, you know, as they need incentives and different things, we try to support Roosevelt and Stevenson for the kids in space, for them to have help to incentivize some things. At Paoa, we also, like this past year, were able to provide support on some supplies type thing. We fund Mana Maoli to provide cultural programs at Paoa. So they do ukulele and choir classes at Paoa. They're also in Lincoln and Stevenson. So through our grant funding, we're supporting for the schools to have cultural programs for youth in the school. So our reach to young people is in many different ways, because a lot of things are being pulled out of the schools, and we're trying to make sure that the kids still have access to different things. So funding of Mana Maoli to remain in our schools, our public schools, is very important, because the kids of Papakōlea go to Paoa if they're on one side of Tantalus, and Lincoln in the other spaces, and then they meet up at Stevenson for middle school and for Roosevelt. And so this past year, we had some of our football boys who needed tutors. So we were able to hire tutors for them so that they could keep their grades up and so that they didn't lose too much playing time. So it's really kind of figuring out how we hear and listen to what the kids are needing and try to help them navigate some of that and be supportive of parents as we're working with them. It's a challenge for our middle school and high school, but we're really trying to be supportive of the school and as well as of community, how we bring activities and resources into space.
That sounds like an amazing programs that y'all are working on. Wow. What has been the reaction from families and the community for all of this?
We've been in community close to 30 years, you know, and it's the good and the bad. I'm not gonna say, you know, everybody's happy, but for the most part, you know, people are supportive. You know, they come out for programs that they want to come out, and we're still there. We work out of the community center, we lease space out of there. I can tell you when we go, because we also provide the community special events. We do the trunk or treat, the Christmas holo-holo, and all of that. We are not short of being able to do a call out to get volunteers. And I think the support that we receive from community overall during COVID shows that there's an appreciation and a support of the work that we do, because we did food distributions and we did all of these different things to support community as a community. So in Papakōlea, if you're serving the keiki and you're serving kupuna, people are, what do you need? We have the tradesmen that we can say, oh, the kupuna step needs repair. Can you guys help us out? And you go do that. And people show up to work and serve community. Papakōlea is a very close-knit community that is still community. Because people are born and raised, they've been there generations. And so to ask for help, or for, we always say, you know, there's no secrets in Papakōlea. And so to know that there's a need and know that people are going to try to help fulfill that need is just the fabric of the community.
That's amazing. Like, it is really all of the things that you're talking about are huge gaps in many communities, and they don't have these types of services and support. So that's amazing that you all are able to do that. Well, let's go to the next section and let's talk about the health prevention services that y'all are providing.
I think for us, health prevention would fall in line also with our research projects, because we're doing community-based participatory research and close to 2 decades. And so our research has been primarily with the University School of Medicine Department of Native Hawaiian Health. And in doing that, it has provided us the opportunity to look at various projects and how we can make a difference and do prevention through that lens. Currently, we're part of a project, Ike Kupuna. Ike Kupuna is a project that was looking at hula. We know we were part of a project where we know hula can help address hypertension. The next leg of that research is looking at whether or not hula can help delay the onset of Alzheimer's. And so collecting that information and that data. So we have been part of research projects that have looked at diabetes prevention or management or maintenance. We are part of a project right now called Ikuanau. And Ikuanau is looking at how do we have those conversations for advanced care planning, and most importantly for homestead communities about succession and planning so that you can avoid a lot of family stress when you know that a successor has been selected for a home before, for the homestead lease before someone has passed away. We're currently working on a project, Pili Aina, that will be looking at once again having families come and grow. They'll get garden boxes to grow vegetables and to learn how to prepare healthy meals. And so I think our prevention has really fallen in line with along the type of research projects that we participate in, and as well as supporting other communities in Pili Aina is Papakōlea homesteads and Kapolei homesteads. our prevention work and looking at collection of data so that we can understand the challenges of what we need and what we're trying to address. So since 2015, we have helped, we've performed research, the Homestead Health Survey, not only in Papakōlea, but in 10 other homestead communities across the state so that you can own your data, be able to look at it and see what it is that you need to do. Prevention is also about bringing community together to do activities. Annually, we have the Ohana Health Fair down at Lincoln School, and we bring in our partners, our health partners, Queens, Emma Clinic, and other health vendors, because for many, that's where they get their screening. For many men, like, we don't go to the doctor, but we do come annually to the health fair and get our blood pressure screen and cholesterol and all of those things so that we're in space and we're knowing, if not at any other time, they are coming in and doing a check-in around health. So that's something we've done over a decade. In bringing our students into space, our nursing and social work students, community will come out and help us to have them do blood pressure screenings and different type of screenings to understand where we are. And as well as we know, a lot of the cultural activities, the hula, we have Lomi Lomi has been in community almost 20 years, where on Thursday evenings, we have a group of traditional practitioners that have been in community, and they do it every Thursday, except for the first Thursday of the month, free of charge for those who need to come in and get Lomi Lomi at the community center. So all of these things are the preventative things that we do in working on behalf of the health of our community.
Something like that, huh?
Yeah. But, you know, it's so much, because on the research side, we've been doing it a while in the various projects, because in my list, they are prevention. You know, we just put to bed last night a curriculum on CBPR, and we were working on a artificial intelligence machine learning tool so that we can do, you know, like a risk assessment of where you enter into a process of health that we are piloting. And so it's all of these different type of things that, you know, are being done in Papakōlea, you know, working to make sure that our community health workers have access to various training and such. So all of that is part of prevention from the lens that we sit in.
How can people connect with y'all? And I mean to volunteer, not just necessarily to take advantage of your services, but to volunteer, to donate, to do things like that, but also to take advantage of your services.
Okay, we are at the Papakōlea Community Center, located at 2150 Tatlas Drive, and my staff is in the lower level. We also have a website. I'm going to say www.kula-papakolea.org. I think that was it, kula-popular.org. And so, you know, we are in those spaces. I think, and of course, we're on Facebook, Kula Nonopoi Hawaii. So we are on social media because of that, this generation. But I think those are the spaces. You got through us through Faith, who's always on social media. But yeah, we are at the Papakōlea Community Center. We are always looking for help. You know, we're getting ready to start the new school year. And I can say, you know, we're going to be looking for, you know, we're always looking for men to come out and be of support. And, you know, that whole mentoring role of, you know, in activities, because they're still missing. We always say, you know, when we retire, we're going to do the book We the Women, because we step up to do this type of work. But yeah, there's a lot of work that can be done, as well as, you know, the schools are looking for people to come in and help read and do different things in Lincoln and various schools that can help. And they're also looking for people to do recreational things after school. And so that too, we know is part of the things we're wanting to help and support as we start this new school year. We have to re-engage with our young people and get them back into more contact with one another and less media stuff. They can do both, but we need to,
yeah. You know,
this relationship building that we need to have, we need to really focus on that, because those years that they lost during COVID of just being around others, we see it, you know? So we're saying, you know, right now, I think they don't need social workers. They need anti-love. We're social workers, but, you know, they just need to know, you know, we got them.